Hi, my name is Jesper and I make videos about data architecture and digital transformation for YouTube. This is part two of the pyramid principle, where I will explain the MECE framework. If you haven't watched my first video, click on the link above. In part one, I explained the SCQA framework. Well, that's quite a mouthful, isn't it? Which is really about how to create a hypothesis. But once we have a hypothesis, we need to do something with it. And that's where this video comes handy. This video is about understanding how we're creating the arguments and the logic to support the hypothesis using inductive and deductive logic. Inductive and deductive logic originates from Greece. Well, to be specific, from ancient Greece. And they were both developed by a dude you've probably heard of, Aristotle. Both inductive and deductive logic both strive toward coming to a truth or to a conclusion, but they approach it very differently. Let's start with deductive logic. Deductive logic begins with a broad truth that is then followed by a major premise which is followed by minor premises. So let's use a very famous example. A major premise might be Socrates is a man. The minor premise would be all men are mortal. And then follows the conclusion, all men are mortal. This is an example of deductive logic. If the major premise is true and the minor premises are also true, then the conclusion must also be, yes, true. Deductive logic is about right and wrong, black and white, true or false. Hence, it's very often used in a scientific context to prove that something is right or wrong. Inductive logic involves drawing conclusions from premises. The conclusion drawn is not necessarily about right or wrong. It is more about the probability or the strength of the conclusion, and it often changes over time. For example, if someone is slurring their words and they smell of alcohol, they might be drunk. So although the premises are true, they are slurring their words and they smell of alcohol, it doesn't necessarily mean they must be drunk. There can be other reasons. Whereas deductive logic is used in science, inductive logic is more used in day-to-day life and is how we are formulating and evolving our beliefs over time. In business, inductive logic often comes first, and then we use deductive logic to support it. So it may work something like this. We're using the SCQA framework to create hypothesis. Then we are using inductive logic to identify a number of scenarios supporting that hypothesis. And then we finally use deductive logic to prove the scenarios. MECE is a framework for inductive logic, and more specifically, an approach or a framework for creating strong premises to support a conclusion or a hypothesis. Now, MECE stands for, and this really is a mouthful, mutually exclusive and collectively exhaustive. So these two frameworks or ways of thinking, they actually work together. So mutually exclusive means that each premise must stand on their own. One premise can't depend on another. Collectively exhaustive means that all premises together must fully support the argument or the hypothesis. There can't be something missing. Let's start with mutually exclusive. It means there can be no overlap between premises. A Venn diagram explains how this works. A good example is the use of H brackets. If the H brackets don't overlap, they are mutually exclusive. If they do overlap, they are mutually inclusive. The problem with overlapping premises is a lack of clarity they bring, as they depend on another premise to be complete. Collectively exhaustive means that all premises are covered that leads to the conclusion. Again, using H brackets, it means that all H brackets must be covered. The problem with missing premises is that the conclusion is not fully supported. Put together, it looks something like this. No H bracket overlaps with another, and taken together, they represent a full H cycle, that is, no H bracket is left out. For example, this would be a clear and good way of pitching a marketing strategy. But if we rearranged it into a non-MECE structure along these lines, well, as you can see, a marketing strategy would be rather confusing. The hypothesis that we want to support is this. To support our medium and long-term goals and aspirations, then we need to redevelop and build an automated and data-driven CRM. So the question is this. How can MECE help us? How can MECE help us come up with the premises to support this hypothesis? There are several ways of approaching it, and this is how we did it. Firstly, we identified a number of CRM issues, and by looking at them, it is clear that they are not MECE. For example, poor analytics and reporting and poor quality data are clearly related. Secondly, we grouped issues together. Remember, inductive logic is not absolute, and conclusions will depend on the situation in which they're analyzed. So in our case, the following grouping made sense. Third, we tested if the groups were mutually exclusive. Increasing cost of selling is about profit, whereas cost of ownership is about cost. Profit and cost are mutually exclusive. Software support is unrelated to profit and cost, and hence also mutually exclusive. Regulatory and legal issues could potentially be related to ending software support, but in our case, they were related to poor quality data. So yes, for us, the four groups are mutually exclusive. And fourthly, we tested if the groups were collectively exhaustive. There were no missing groups or premises, making it collectively exhaustive. Hence, we came to the conclusion that the groups or premises were MECE. I hope this has explained inductive and deductive logic and how to use the MECE framework to create strong arguments or premises supporting a hypothesis. If you enjoyed this video, please hit the like and subscribe button. Thank you for watching and see you in my next video.